Good afternoon, everyone. In today's class, I will explain two concepts. One is butterfly effect in MTI radar. In last class, we already discussed about MTI radar basic principle and what do you mean by an MTI radar, how it is differentiated with continuous wave radar, and what is the main function of this MTI radar. And two different types of MTI radars. One is MTI radar with power amplifier transmitter, and another one is MTI radar with power oscillator transmitter, right? Both the MTI radars are differ in terms of transmitter blocks only. Remaining is same, right? I think my voice is audible and slides are visible to everyone, right? If any problem, please let me know. Okay, in today's class, I will explain the concept called butterfly effect in MTI radar. Okay, first I will explain this butterfly effect in MTI radar with diagrams. Okay, next I will explain the concept, right? So we know the basic concept where we observe the outputs of an echo signals in a radar system. After processing all the echo signals received by a radar receiver, that is processed by using radar processing unit. After processing all the information related to that echo signal, that processed information regarding target is displayed on the A-scope, that is radar display. We have several radar displays. That was a separate topic in your radar system subject. Okay, we will discuss. But most commonly used radar display is A-scope, right? So, if you consider a MTI radar, and if you observe for one sweep, actually I already told that integration of radar pulses concept. What is the integration of radar pulses, ma? Instead of considering one single echo pulse, we are considering n number of echo pulses, right? So for what we are doing that? To increase the probability of detection and to decrease the probability of false alarm, and to increase the accuracy of results, and to increase the resolution properties of the images what you have to observe on the radar display, right? So ma, so see ma here. Actually, this figure A indicates the echo signal at one sweep, right? This is the signal at one sweep, and after next, this is the signal at second sweep, and these are the signals of several sweeps up to A to E, A, B, C, D, E. These are the several echo signals received at several sweeps. Here, sweep is nothing but one scan. This is one scan pulse, and this is another scan. This is another scan. So that means it scans targets at several times. Okay, that means this is first transmitting pulse, second transmitting pulse, third, fourth, fifth transmitting pulse towards the target in order to scan same target, right? Same area, right? But to get the better results, to improve the probability of detection and to decrease the probability of false alarm, several, that means n number of echo pulses are considered. Okay, already we know the concept from the integration of radar pulses. I already explained the concept integration of radar pulses. So here we are considering a sweep from small a to small g, right? This is the superimposition of all the pulses. F figure is nothing but, F graph is nothing but superimposition of all the pulses. So here butterfly effect in MTI radar is very important concept. Seema here, butterfly effect is nothing but if you observe all the returned echo pulses from all the sweeps from A to E, here each sweep consists of moving target echo and stationary. If you see ma, concept is very simple here. Actually, we send an electromagnetic pulse into a free space. Okay, that pulse may be hit the stationary target, it may be hit the moving target, but our aim is our focus is to detect the moving targets by using a MTA radar, right? But there may be a chance of hitting stationary targets also, right? That is called clutter. That echoes are called clutter. So if you observe this waveform consists of clutter echoes as well as moving target echoes also, okay? But it is not differentiated or not identified by using a single sweep. So in order to differentiate clutter echoes and moving target echoes, we need to consider n number of echoes. So that's why here they consider from A to E. So when you consider from A to E, there is a some fundamental principle to identify the moving targets and to differentiate the moving target echoes from the stationary target echoes, where stationary target echoes are called the clutters, right? I think concept is clear. So if you observe these graphs, if you consider this is the echo pulse, right? This is one echo pulse, this is another echo pulse, and this is another echo pulse, right? With a one sweep, right? For the stationary targets, in all the sweeps, the amplitude of an echo pulse is same. Yeah, the concept is for a stationary target, for a stationary target echoes, that means clutter echoes, the echo signal from all the sweeps, the echo signal for all the sweep times, regarding stationary target echo, the amplitude should be same. So if you consider this echo pulse, this is having the same amplitude at this sweep, and here also it is having the same amplitude, and here also it is having the same amplitude, here and here. After the superimposition of all the pulses also, the stationary targets are having same amplitude. There is no shift in amplitude of the echoes of a stationary clutter echoes, right? Or if you observe this echo, which is shown with an arrow mark, this is having some amplitude level here, and this is varies with the time. This is having some another amplitude, some other, and here it is having constant value. That means the moving target echo signal is having varying amplitude with respect to time, with respect to the traveling mode, right? So it is having a varying amplitude. And if you observe this echo also, it is also having less amplitude here, more amplitude here, less here, constant here, and less here, right? So in this manner, you can easily identify what are the echoes of moving targets and what are the echoes of the stationary targets, right? But if you observe the single sweep pulse, it is not at all possible to differentiate which echo pulses are from the stationary targets and which echo pulses are from the moving targets, right? That's why we are considering n number of sweeps. So by continually comparing these n number of echo pulses, the echo pulse which is having a constant amplitude in all the sweeps, those echo pulses are from the stationary targets. Those are the low frequency echo components, and those are from the stationary targets, and those are called as the clutter signals, right? And the echo pulse which is having a varying amplitude for all n number of sweeps, those are called as moving target echoes, because there is a shift in frequency, right? So this frequency is varies and amplitude is also varies. So these are the echoes from the moving targets, right? So here the echo signal from the stationary target is this one, and the arrow represented two echoes are called the echoes from the moving targets, right? And here we are also having some other echo pulse which is having the uniform amplitude throughout all the sweeps. So this is also the echo from the stationary target, right? This is a clutter echo, right? So now by examining n number of sweeps, we identified what are the stationary echo components of stationary targets and what are the echo components of a moving target, right? For based on the integration of radar pulses, if you superimpose all these sweeps, we will get the waveform like this here. See this one. After superimposing n number of pulses also, the echoes from stationary targets are having the same amplitude like this, and it spreads only that interval only. When you compare this moving target echo pulses, this is threaded like this. So this is, what is the shape of this mark? This is in the shape of butterfly, right? So actually, this is in the shape of butterfly. That's why we call this effect as butterfly effect in MTI radar. So this is called the butterfly effect in MTI radar, right? So I think now you got a concept of what is butterfly effect in MTI radar. I repeat again. See, I repeat the basic lines here. See. So what do you mean by butterfly effect in MTI radar, Ma? So when you observed output of an MTI radar on radar display, what is output of an MTI radar? Output of an MTI radar consists of output of an MTI radar consists of a echoes of stationary targets as well as echoes from the moving targets, right? So now all these are displayed on the radar display of an MTI radar. So when you observed that display, you identified several echo pulses, echo from the stationary targets and echoes from the moving targets also, right? So now what is the task of MTI radar? You mean MTI radar, it should differentiate echoes of stationary targets and echoes of the moving targets, because the function of MTI radar is it should eliminate echoes from the stationary targets and it should display an echoes of the moving targets, because it is the moving target indicator, right? So it should display only echoes of a moving echoes or videos of moving target indicators only. It should not display echoes of the stationary targets. Okay, so it should first identify what are the echoes of moving targets and what are the echoes of moving targets, right? After identifying, after differentiating both, it can eliminate echoes from the stationary targets by using the concept called delay line cancellation. That is separate topic. That is the next topic of your syllabus, right? So for that purpose, first it should differentiate these two, echoes of the stationary targets and echoes of the moving target. So in order to differentiate, it is not possible by considering a single sweep. So it is not possible. So see here, it is not possible by considering a single sweep. This is the single sweep, right? This is the two sweeps for the same target, right? For the same surveillance area, right? It is not, because we can't say which one is the moving target and which one is the stationary target, right? So to examine that, we are considering n number of echo pulses. After observing n number of echo pulses, some echoes are having constant amplitude at all the sweeps. Such echoes are called as an echoes from the stationary targets, but some echoes are varying, having a varying amplitude. So such echoes are called as moving target echoes, right? So by observing this phenomena, you can easily identify what are the clutter echoes and what are the moving target echoes, right? Now, if you superimpose all these echoes, if you integrate all these echoes, you have a display like this. What is the display here? The echo from the stationary target is still in the same shape, having the same amplitude. But echoes from the moving target, when they are having a different amplitude, when they superimpose each other, they are in the shape of butterfly. That's why we are called this type of effect in MTI radar is called as butterfly effect in MTI radar. But you need to eliminate this one, right? So you need to eliminate these stationary targets, right? So for that purpose, we are going to the concept called delay line canceller. Okay, so here delay line canceller is nothing but this delay line canceller actually a filter, ma. This is a small low frequency filter, LPF, right? So because the echo signals from the stationary components or DC components, right? The AC is the high frequency component and the DC is the low frequency component, right? So in order to avoid that low frequency component, basically we designed a filter. That filter is called as delay line canceller, where delay line canceller is nothing but a DC filter, which filters the low frequency components, which are nothing but echoes from the stationary targets, right? and which allows the SA components of an echo signal. That means from the non-stationary targets, those are the moving targets. And we have a several types of echoes, right? In this we have the several types of echoes. So these echoes, so these echoes are nothing but